Welcome to our channel. In this video, we'll learn about the user or local variables with multiple live examples such as value type, list type, array type, and the random variable. So let's start. Before moving to that, you should know what is variable. So the variable is a storage location. Variables are used to store your information to be referenced and manipulated in a computer. So you can assign the values into the variable and you can use or refer the variable at any time in your automation task. You can do that. And in the user or local variables, we have four types of variable: value type, list type, array type, and the random variables. Let's start with value type variables. For that, just go to Automation Workbench. In the right side, you can see three options: Error View, Variable Manager, Bot Dependencies. For the variable, just click on Variable Manager. Here you can see already two local variables are available: MyList variable and the prompt assignment. These are all predefined variables that are already provided by the Automation Anywhere. When you click on this MyList variable, you can see the predefined values: my value 1, my value 2, my value 3, something is available. Either you can delete or change the values, add to list or anything. Or else if you want to proceed, you can continue with the same things. Like the same in the prompt assignment, we have text values. So you can use or either you can change or delete the prompt assignment. That's up to you. In order to create the user variables, just click on add. In the bottom, you can see add. You can see the window with variable type, name, select, values. So in the variable type, the first option should be value. So I'll show you the values first. Next, I'll show you the list, array, and random. So the value and the name. So here you cannot add any spaces. You can add any symbols or any numeric values, but you cannot give the spaces. So now I'll use value var1. So this is the first example. So I'll use a value variable 1. So just for your reference, you can give any names. For reference, you can give that. And the regular expression checkbox, this is nothing but this is a mathematical calculation, something like the symbols. Using this symbol, you can find or replace anything in the words. But in our case, we are not going to use the regular expressions. So if you want to learn about the regular expressions, please watch my next video. And log for analytics. This will create the analytics variable. So this also, some complex task. In my next videos, I will explain each and everything. And in the select, our first task is value, right? So I'll use the value first. Next, I will show you how to read the data from text files. So in the value, either you can give any kind of text. It can be numeric or any kind of text you can use. So here I am using just Automation Anywhere text. Once you have done, just click on save. So in order to show the value in the variables, I will use a message box. Message box, I will display the variable. Just press F2. And value variable 1. Click on insert, save the task and execute. Now you can see the results in the message box. We have created the variable with the text variable and we can see the values in the message box. You can see the message box is displayed. Exact value has been displayed. So at the same, I'll show you how to add the values without any text. So value without text, perfect. Okay. At this time, we are adding the values, but without any text. So using this variables, you can assign or use the for reference. I'll show you that value variables. I have selected the variable type as value and name. I have given the name. After that, I have not selected any checkboxes and I have not updated any values. Just I am clicking on save and you will get the prompt like you are assigning null values. Yeah, I am assigning. So I will show you how to use that one. So I will use the loop function. The loop times 5 times. So just use the variable operation. In the commands panel, you can see variable operations. Using the variable operations, just select the variable, the value without text variable. Now, my current requirement is I need to increment the values using the counter. So count here, counter plus 5. So previously I have not assigned, null values has been assigned to the value without text variable. But in this loop, I am going to assign the counter plus 5. So which means the first time it will consider as 6, next time 7, after that 8, something like that. It will increment each and every time. So here you can see, I have assigned the value to value without text variable. Perfectly I have assigned. Now I have executed the task, so you can see the results. The task has been executed, runtime window has been started. So very simple, just I have not given any variables. In the message box, I will display the count. Press F2, value without text, you click on insert, save, enable. At this time you can see how I am using the without values. I am assigning here in the loop, I am assigning counter plus without text, which means it will increment it each and every time, 8, 9, 10, perfect. We have used the value without text. Next I will show you how to read the data from text file. Value read text file. So for that you need to create one of the notepad file, and the name should be there, value read text, copy, you need to paste equal sign. After that you need to give the text. Previously we have give the text as automation anywhere. Now I will give the text as automation anywhere 1 2 3, something like that. I will give and save the notepad file. Now I need to browse and select the particular notepad file. So the variable type, perfect. Once you have done, just click on save. So here the variable has been assigned, value read text. In message box I will display the value. Press F2, value read text, click on save. So I will execute the task so you can see. Perfect. I will open the notepad so you can see exact results. In the notepad what I have done is value read text is equal sign automation anywhere 1, 2, 3. So in the message box you can see, you cannot see the value read text, but you can see the value automation anywhere 1, 2, 3. Since the value read text is the name, so just you want to ensure that you are using the same name in the notepad also. In the text file you need to use the same name, whatever the name you have provided in the variable manager, you need to use the same name, then you need to use the equal sign. So now it will consider this is only the text values, whatever the values available after the equal sign, it will consider everything as a text and it will update. Very simple, we have done. So I'll disable and I'll show you how to use the list variables. Variable type is list and the name, list variable 1. So I'll make the name as list variable 1. Here you can add numeric values or any kind of text or anything you can add. So I'll use 10, click on add to list, 12, 14, 15, perfect. That's it, that is enough, you know. So here, and here we have a checkbox called as make random. So currently we have an order, right? 10, 12, 14, 15 in order. So if you want to make this in a random order, you can check this checkbox or just leave it. And here also we have two options, value and read from text file. Value is nothing but, so here we have created a list values. So if you want to copy from the read from text file, you can use the other options. So now proceed with the value options and click on save. In the loop function, we have a list options. So I'll show you. In the list drop down, you can see list variable 1. So using this, you can see the values. So the same, I'll display the message box with the variable. Within this, just you need to press F2 and select your list variable. Very simple. Whatever the list variables are available in that, it will display each and every time. You know, in the for loop function, it will display each and every values. First time it is displaying 10, next time 12, 14, 6, 15, something like that displayed. Exactly, we got all the results. So next I will show you how to use the list function from the notepad files. list var notepad, and here we need to select the option as read from text file. Then you need to browse the file. So here already we have a value type variable, right? So here itself you can create the variable the same. You need to use the name. Previously we have given the name as value read text for value variable. At this time, for this list operation, I am using value read text equal sign 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, something like that. Here you need to use comma or semicolon, since the automation will consider only the comma and semicolon symbols in the comma separated list, separate list, no? Or else if you are assigning without the comma, it will consider the single text. So perfect. Just you need to browse the file, variables type. So here you can have the multiple variables such as value table, value variable, as well as the list variable in the single file. Based on the names, it will extract the information. You know, here you can see list variable notepad. So I missed to copy and paste. Super. So based on the name, it will read your text. So in the value variable, it will read the first text. In the list variable, based on the list variable notepad text, it will read the second line. Based on that, it will provide the output. So just click on save. So the list variable notepad is ready. Same, use the list variable notepad at this time. Click on save. In the message box, I will display the values. Press F2, list variable notepad at this time. Click on save. Save the task and execute. Now you can see the results. In the notepad, we have typed 16, 18, something like that. That will be displayed in the message box. Perfect. 16, 18, 20, 22, 24. Perfect. All the values based on the name. That's very, very important. Based on the name which you have provided in the automation anywhere, the same name should be in the notepad, then only it can recognize. If you are not providing this name in the notepad, it cannot recognize your text, you know. That's very, very important point. So we have done. I'll disable. We'll move to the array variables. So the array variables is nothing but the same, like this list, the array, it will give you the exact results. So just give the name as array value, or else array 1. Select here, you can assign any values, particular values, or read from CSV or Excel files, read from database, or anything like that you can use. And in the value option, you need to initialize the values. Here you can add rows or column, something like that. So I'll 10. I'll give my name, Dinesh. 12. So just we have added two columns and two rows. That's it. Very simple. Just click on save. Now the value has been stored in the arrays. Now we want to display the array values. For that, you can use Okay, two rows and two columns are available. For that, we can use the loop function. In the loop list, we don't have an array, so we can use the times options. So in the times options, array rows. Array rows, which is nothing but it will display how many rows are available in the particular array variable. So we have created only one variable, array one. It will display how many list of rows are available in the particular array. So I'll display in the message box first, so you can see the results. I'll use the message box to display array rows and array columns. Array rows, select variable. After that, press F2, array columns. Click on insert. You need to select the array variable, the same name. In the local variable, you can see array 1 has been defined, the same name. These options, you know, these are all system variables, system defined variables. This will help you to find the how many number of rows and the columns were available in the automation anywhere. So now we are going to use this array rows to number of times. So usually we are giving the number of times such as 5, 10, something like that, right? But now we want to give the exact number of rows. Or else, you know, if you are giving 5, 10, something like that, unwantedly it will loop multiple times, right? So in order to avoid that, you can use the rows, array 1. So now it can consider the times 2. If it's increasing 3, 4, something like that, automatically it will increase. Based on the variable, it will get increased. So now we have assigned. In the message box, I will display the variable. F2, array variable, array 1. When you click on insert, it will ask you to enter the row number and the column numbers. So row 1, column 1. In the next in the same message box, I will display array row 2, column 2. Array 1, row 2, column 2. So the row 2, column 2 is, which is nothing but in the initialization, we have given two rows and two columns, right? The initialized value, you can see we have provided two rows and the two column values. So that in the message box, I am giving the array row 1, column 1, array column 2, row 2, column 2. Very simple. Using this function, you can extract all the information, or else we have one more options. By this way, it will take so much of time, you know, for the array 1, row 1, comma 1, you need to extract, and array 1, comma 2, then array 2, comma 1, array 2, comma 2, something like that you need to enter. For that very simple options, you can use in the row values, you can use the counter functions. The counter will help you to count each and every time the first values. So in the for loop, you can see the counter will consider the first time it's 1, second time 2, third time 3, something like that. So you press F2, array. In the row value, I will use the counter variable. And at this time, column value should be 2. Perfect. Now we can run this. So we don't need a multiple lines. Just we have used counter. Instead of previously, we have given 1. But at this time, we have given perfect. In the task, you can see we have two values, two rows. Even if I am adding more rows and more columns, it will not affect. 14, test and add rows. 15, values. I'll click on save. At this time, counter will works like the first time it will consider as 1, second time 2, third time 3, something like that. It will automatically it will change. Previously, we have given 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, something like that. you know, we need to increment, but using this counter formula, we don't need to manually increment. The counter itself, it will increment at each and every time within the for loop. So directly we can use the counter function. So now I'll save the task and execute. So you can see the results immediately. Very simple. Currently we have added 3 more rows. 10th in hash, 14 test, 15 values, 12 automation anywhere. All the value has been displayed. Just we have used the, using the counter variable, we have displayed all the variable, which is very simple. You know, instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have used this. So if you want to change the column also, you can use the counter variable, or else in the other variable operation, based on the value, you can choose anything. With the array variable, next I will show you how to read the data from Excel or CSV files. Array Excel. At this time, we are going to read the data from CSV or Excel file. First, choose the Excel file. Okay, here I have a sample file with three or four records, I believe. I'll open this sample file so you can see. Perfect. I have 2, 4, 5 records. Player 1 to player 5, I have records, and I have runs for the same. First, browse the sample file. And here we have multiple options: all cells, entire row, entire column, and the entire range. In this, we can use A1 to C15 or something like that. Or else, if you want to extract all the informations, in all cells informations, you can use all cells. In my case, I will use the all cells. Or else, you can use the A1 to, currently we have data from A1 to B6. So either you can use the range A1 to B6 option. Just click on save. In the array Excel, we have created and we have saved the variable. So in the same loop, we can display the values. So using the loop function, now we need to create the times. Add the times array Excel, array rows. Array rows, click on insert. It will ask you to select the variable. Previously we have used array 1. At this time we are going to use the array Excel. So at this time the times will be considered as 6. Previously we had only 2 rows, but at this time it will consider the number of times would be 6. Click on save. Even first I can display the values in the message box. Array rows. Array rows, click on insert and array Excel. So I'll disable this code. First I'll run this message box so you can see the results. How many number of rows were available in the Excel, particular Excel, it will display in the message box. I have executed the task so you can see the results. The runtime window has been started. Now the message box will be displayed. The number 6, I am expecting the results as 6. Perfect. We can see the results perfectly. So I'll disable this one and enable. Already we have provided the array loop as selected the array Excel. So we have done. In the message box at this time, what you have to do, you need to press F2 and choose the array Excel, click on insert, the row value and the column value. The row values is nothing but these are all the rows, and A and B is the columns. So the column name 1 and 2 we have values, row values it's incrementing each and every time. So now also we can use the counter variable. So basically the counter will starts with 1 or 2, just you want to check So first column 1, after that array XL, at this time also counter and column 2. So I'll execute the task so we can see the results. Counter is very simple functions. First time it will consider as 1, second time 2, third time 3, something like that. It will increment each and every time. Instead of we are giving the name in the variable, so you can see the XL values are displaying in the message box. Dollar symbol is, you know, I missed to delete the dollar symbol, so it's reflecting. But in the player 3, 11, column 1 and the column 2 values are exactly displaying in the message box. So perfect. For the same, you know, in order to read the data from CSV or text file, you can use the other options such as read from CSV or text files. The same option we can use instead of array functions, you can do. Next, we'll see about the random variables. So what is random variables? In the random variables also we need to give the name. So the random one first I'll give, and here you can use random string or random number. First I will show you how the random string functions will work. Here you know it will jump into characters, such as it will includes numeric values and the text values and the symbols. Everything will be available in the random strings. You can give any string length. Now I will give 8 or something, 8. Now I will give the 8, just click on save. And in the message box, it's a single value, so you don't need to add a loop function. Press F2, random, click on insert, save and execute the task. Perfect. Here you can see it displaying some of the random new text here, you know, very random text. You can see the values. So after that we have numeric values, the random type, random number between that, random two values, random two as a name. From now I'll give 10 to 1000. So it can be any random numbers. It will pick any of the random number and it will display it. So just I have given the name and I have choose the random number or range option at this time. Enable random 2, click on save and save the task and execute. Now you can see the results for the particular random 2. Between 10 to 1000 it will display the values. It can be any numbers. Yeah, now it is being 600. So when we are executing again, we will get the different option, different, you know, different numbers, 671. So again if you are trying, you will get the different random numbers. It can be between 10 to 1000. You will get some of the options. So use a type variable, list type variable and the array variables. So the random variables. Hope I have covered everything. I believe you learned something today. Really thanks for your time and thanks for watching these videos. Already have uploaded multiple videos about the Automation Anywhere and the other programming languages such as HTML, JavaScript and the other videos. So when you have a time, please watch all the videos, like and subscribe our channel. Really thanks for your time. Don't forget to subscribe. Please subscribe. Thank you. Bye-bye.